see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior. move for good, for the Lamb had conquered death, and the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who'd come to the Father are restored, and the church of Christ was born, then the Spirit lit the flame, now this gospel truth of old shall not give.
joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven in heaven in nature sing. He has come.
He has come.
Sing joy. Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King.
it to me. Oh, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. Oh, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. This joy.
I've got the joy, joy.
And in him is all things, and from him comes all things. 'Cause in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. And in him all things were created. Yes. Yes. And from him comes all things, and in him is all things, and from him.
Enter the holy place. You made a way for me to enter the holy place. You made a way for me to enter the holy place. You made a way for me to enter the hole, and I am yours, and you are mine, and we'll be together forever. One day in your house, without. presence is my home.
Thousands
elsewhere. Better is one day in your hands. Better is one day in your hearts. Better is one day in your courts than thousands elsewhere. And better is one day in your courts. Better is one day in your hearts. Better is one day in your courts than thousands elsewhere. And better is.
My breath, you're my life. all. You're my bread, you're my life, you're my everything. In you is all. Just one.
whatever it sounds like, whatever it feels like. Just let worship arise in this moment. True worship arise in this moment.
I just want you. Joy, I can't explain it.
like water to my soul. Your word is a lamp to my feet. And Jesus, I love you. And I love you. Your name is like honey on my lips. Your spirit.
Jesus, we do love you more than anything. We love you, Jesus. Our hearts look at you, Lord. We see you. We behold the Lamb of God, and we say we love you, Lord. Thank you for filling us this morning. Thank you for coming every time. We honor you. We honor you, Lord. We honor you, King. What a privilege to be in your presence. Where else could we go? We love you, Lord. We're going to step into communion in this moment. If you're watching online, if you want to get your communion elements ready, such a beautiful peace in the room. I'm sure you feel it in your homes. He is the Prince of Peace. And during worship, I just heard the words in Isaiah chapter 9. It says, "For unto us a son is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." It's who he is. This is Jesus. And so as we come to the table of the Lord today and we take the bread, and in this Christmas season, God put on flesh. He put on flesh for us. That baby at the mercy of his mother. That fragile, tender baby who came to die that we may live. That's our King. And Lord, we come to the table and we lift this bread this morning and we see you, Jesus. We see you, Lord, as the one who came, the one who chose to come to bear every lash upon your back, every stripe for our healing,
that crown of thorns placed on your head for our healing. And so, Lord, may in this season we behold you rightly, your great sacrifice for your deep love for us, to be one with us for our healing, for our redemption, Lord. So we come to this table so thankful this morning. Thank you for your broken body on that cross for our healing. Lord, we love you and we tell you today we're thankful. Thank you for every healing. As we partake today, Lord, let bodies be made whole. In Jesus' name, let us receive life this morning. In your precious name, amen.
Oh, we thank you, Lord, that we get to come to the Father's table. This beautiful table where sons and daughters get to sit and partake of you. Partake of you with you. As the guest of honor, as the host, as the meal, as the table that is set before us. It is you and you alone, Jesus. So we thank you for the cup of the new covenant, the cup of your suffering, the cup of your blood. For you are the one that mediates this new covenant between God and his people. And we thank you for it, Jesus. This precious blood that has brought us into your very own presence, this precious blood of a pure and spotless lamb. Jesus, we thank you that you have justified us by this blood. You have redeemed us by this blood. You have sanctified us by this blood. It is by your blood that we could come boldly as sons and daughters to the throne of grace. We are so thankful as a family today that we are blood bought. We are covered in your precious blood. Though our sins may have been red like scarlet, you have made us white as snow. It is by your blood and your blood alone. We stand as redeemed Christians, believers, saying yes and amen to this new covenant. So we thank you for it, Jesus. And we remember every suffering, every bruise, every scratch on your body, every blister. We remember, Jesus, and we say thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's take. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Jesus. I pray you are glorified today. In Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to continue giving of ourselves. As you guys know, every week we get an amazing opportunity to give into the hands of Jesus. And even those watching online, you guys, week after week, you may join us in worship. And as you hear musicians playing and people jumping and singing and shouting, well, it doesn't end there. It continues straight into giving true substance into his hands. Luke chapter 7, I'm going to read real quick in verse 36, and we all know the story, but it's just beautiful to remember what was given in this moment. It says, one of the Pharisees asked Jesus to have dinner with him, so Jesus went to his home and sat down to eat. When a certain immoral woman, from the city heard he was eating there, she brought a beautiful alabaster jar filled with expensive perfume. Then she knelt behind him at his feet, weeping. Her tears fell on his feet, and she wiped them off with her hair. And then she kept kissing his feet and putting perfume on them. We know this is a beautiful display of worship that we get of an immoral woman sitting at the feet of Jesus, but we cannot forget that there was an actual, tangible substance that was given to God that she actually worked for. That was hers. That was expensive, the scriptures say. And so that's why this is worship, because it is all unto him. Whether we're lifting our hands, we're raising our voice, we're crying, we're weeping, our heart posture is towards him, it's all worship. But so is giving into his hands financially with something tangible that he has given to us, which is wild. It's an actual tangible offering that we can give into the actual hands of the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why we invite you guys week after week to give into his hands. How many of you guys know if an immoral woman in scripture can give an expensive, lavish gift to the Lord, how much more for us that are redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, that have seen what he has done in our life, that truly have tasted and seen that the Lord is good, that we can do it as well. Why? Because he is worthy of every penny that we have. Why? Because he's given it all to us anyways. And so let's pray and let's thank the Lord that we can give into his hands. Jesus, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, that we get to worship you with our finances. We get to worship you with our paycheck. We get to worship you with the fruit of our labor. It is an honor, Lord, to give directly into your hands. I pray you bless every giver in this room, every giver that's watching online. Bless their homes, bless their families, Jesus. We thank you that you are still the God that owns a cattle on 1,000 hills. You own the earth and the fullness thereof. Every good and perfect gift comes down from you, the Father of lights. We love you and we thank you, Jesus, in your precious, beautiful name. Amen.